There's being a peak to burn. Hope that's on the video.
The shoe, why with this part, is much more malleable. It's sort of plastic in its texture. And it's fairly easy to shape accurately and carefully when it's fairly hot. So rather than make the shoe, cool it off, take it over to the foot and see how it fits. You have to be careful and you have to be judicious in your application of heat to the foot. You don't want to just put a great big red hot shoe on the bottom and hold it shorter, 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 because you don't want to make it so short that the horse is uncomfortable. But there is quite a buffer. Another thing about that, doesn't hurt the horse at all, and it enhances your ability to fit the shoe accurately and properly to the horse's foot. The other thing is it does is it makes an ash mark. It makes a burn mark
to the hoof wall.
And you can take a shoe like that, once it's been fitted and the clip burned in properly, you can take it over, put it on the foot, and tap it into place with your hammer, and it gets enough of a mechanical lock that it'll stay there on its own until you get your nails in it and get it nailed up properly. The most important thing about that is that it doesn't hurt the horse's foot at all.
Bottom of a living animal's leg, and it's fine, it's okay, it doesn't hurt them at all.
Next to the fire, and the leather got really tough and hard, so it was the sole of a sandal, it was turned up on the edges, it had holes in it, and they sort of laced it on the bottom of the foot like a sandal. Well, that didn't work very well, the leather didn't last very long, it's kind of hard to keep it tied on in the right place. So then they tried the same thing with metal. They made a metal plate turned up on the edges with holes in it around the edge, and still was the tying on part was not very effective. It didn't last very long. So finally, some brave soul figured out you could punch holes in a piece of metal, and they nailed a piece of metal, a flat piece of metal on the bottom of the foot. The shoe and the foot, and then they get a little mark burned on the front for the clip. Then they take their knife or their nippers and they carve that out, they make that hole bigger. Rather than having to burn all the way into that wall, they get a mark, then they use their knife and enlarge the hole, make the spot bigger, then they burn again, until they get the clip in, burned in deeply enough where the front of the clip is flush with the hook wall. And the clip actually becomes a part of the hook wall. Again, I describe that kind of like the pieces of a...
I'll just make this as I would normally make it at the moment.
Right.
If you when they did slow it down, make sure I'm happy to do that. I'll just knock the shoe up at the moment, right? And you want to see then where the hinge should be at certain times, just take foot bits and I'll do that. Yeah.
Okay.
Is it ice curling? What is that thing that they do on the ice? Is it on the ice?
Brooms, the curling club. We're seeing that.
That's the ice. That's an Olympic thing, isn't it?
I don't know.
That's an Olympic event. Curling is an Olympic event.
Yeah.
Everyone's got a couple of curling irons on their heart. No, all I know about
did you see them guys sweeping it?
Yeah, well, remember the little movie?
Yeah, and they're like grooming in front of the
door. Yeah, that's all I know.
That's cheating. You shouldn't. How about not brooming? No brooming.
What, mental telepathy?
Yeah, you gotta watch out for those ice rocks.
Like we used to do that, or just went here, through the
floor, and never. Just did it all.
So that was how you iron.
No, yeah. Okay.
And I had to keep it a lot longer. So it's a waste of time trying to do it like the weather. Unless you can, but you know what to do.
Yeah.
It's very cool to have a tripod like
that. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I learned that.
That particular point. I really only try and get the heels up. I don't worry too much about my heels because I'm going to give it a heat anyway normally to finish it off. So I just get near enough at that stage and get the heels.
In that kid enough anyway.
Hey.
You put enough money into your son, you can take his tools, can't
probably,
you?
Yeah.
Oh,
Any for choice. At some point, you're going to get that hook in there. Right. Right for that one.
To me, that is such a David move.
Like you.
She has some great ideas for a project.
you ever get a video of the Brazil brothers striking?
That's what I want, no.
No.
Oh, what?
The Brazil brothers striking the European way. It's so different in the way most people strike here.
Those guys are like power hammers.
Yeah, if they do it right, it is even power hammers.
Yeah.
One of the CBAs, I wish I had a video of it, was Brazil brothers and Tom Hart all striking together, and it's quite a show.
Were there three sledges going then?
Yeah. We were at a horseshoe meet.
It wasn't Jim Moore. How many guys are running in on that chainmaking video?
I haven't seen it yet.
Oh.
I don't have a copy of it.
Oh, they were looking at it over on King's track, I guess. I think there's about six or seven guys in sledges coming in to seal the weld on a big chain.
Oh, is that right?
Really hear the difference in that fire when you let it breathe a little better.
Leave it to a musician to notice that.
Thank you. Yep. Heat waves. So I tried to take a picture up close and I got heat waves.
I was trying to keep my quarters as far back as I could when I was meeting them yesterday for the hindi, and they still weren't far enough back, you know. It was a job trying to get them far enough back.
So you would first trim at the foot and then off of that and then do your math and go to
the... So what are you guys?
Yeah, he does. He does look great.
Yeah, he does.
So we had him down on the floor.